this point.
I think it was nerfed from the beta, if I remember correctly, because it was a pretty fun weapon to use in the beta. Obviously, we had a lot smaller maps at that point as it was just being introduced, but...
Okay, so... Okay, so apparently we've been told that the player is actually in the server. It's just he's not showing up on the UI. So it is being played out. It's just we don't see the fourth player, interestingly.
Yeah.
So,
but
so
bear with us. The player is definitely getting those kills as SAS were in the lead.
Yeah.
So Rukafilth goes ahead and snags one for VRespawn.
So bear with us on the casting side of this, as we're going to try to figure this out as much as you do. As we've got Saltcaster on the UI. Yeah, I don't see his teammate, though.
Yeah, I'm not even seeing, like,
I don't know if he's just, like... His,
could just be a spectator,
interesting.
But...
If someone, if someone dies, like, randomly without seeing another player, then we know that he's there. But as far as we can see, it's just Saltcaster right now. Either way, he's going to be working his way back at the moment. Trying to fall into a more passive position.
Nice use of the sonar there as he falls back, though, to try and make sure that he knows the direction
yeah.
that defender is going to be coming. Since he will be coming at it blind, essentially, it's good for him to have that information right away. And then we see Saltcaster here just getting piled upon by the VRespawn team. Both members just...
Okay, so he is there.
Yeah, I just
because there was a trade.
Yeah.
We just...
We can't...
We can't... He's, like, literally not spawned in on the spectator point of view. So basically, the way you guys have to read this is if someone from VRespawn dies randomly, then it's the guy from SAS that's missing.
Yeah. I really feel like the kid
like
is Sixth Sense right now.
Like that.
I can see a lot of dead people, but I can't see the person who's killing them.
So Stu will go down to the ghost member of SAS. And in the meanwhile, Rukafelt's going to be fighting this... I think Rukafel's fighting.
We don't know what Rukafel's doing.
Stu's going to kill Saltcaster in the meanwhile. And yeah, we're just going to keep on trucking.
Yeah, we are. We don't need no stinking player models.
Okay, so we do have, I believe, confirmation now that this is going to be restarted.
We think.
We believe. So yeah, interesting. Don't really know what to think of that.
Well, I think we got a good preview of what's to come.
At least we know it's going to be relatively close, right?
Yeah, I mean, the frags,
hopefully.
The frags are there. I mean, it's currently 12 to 7.
If the first map is any indication, anyway.
Yeah.
I like how you put air quotes on 12 to
Well, I mean, 7. If they're restarting it,
as
right?
If, like, the scoreboard was also broken or something like that.
No, scoreboard's right, but...
Nothing is confirmed.
Don't
question everything you see. That's the model we're working with right now in game.
Yeah.
They're still fighting though. That's the weird part. That's what like why we're if you're wondering where we're like kind of going silent every few seconds is because we're trying to both peer down and figure out what's going on in game. Because we have received confirmation this is going to be restarted, but the players are still continuing on play, probably because well they're in VR headsets and you don't get Discord notifications when you're in a VR headset.
Nope.
Unless you've got like a mod for that or something, which I don't think that exists, does it?
Well,
does it exist?
One of the beautiful things about the Oculus headset, Blue, is that you do have the option through the Oculus Home to use Dash, which
that's true, yeah.
Which you can pop out windows and things like that and pin them into your VR space. So yeah, technically you could have Discord open, though we do not encourage that,
yeah,
as we don't want to encourage any sort of illicit behaviors.
It's probably also not too transducive to competitive play if you have a giant Discord window in your face blocking like an eighth of your screen space.
Yeah, that's true as well. You're going to give up a lot of your FOV, which is very crucial in VR right now as we do have a fairly limited FOV and we don't have that natural kind of 120 or 130. I forget what the actual FOV is on the human eye. But yeah, we definitely don't get that.
Maybe you could put it behind you or something like that.
Good. Maybe.
Just be like, oh, you hear the ping, you just whip your neck real quick. Gotta be careful, obviously.
Yeah, that added weight on your head, man. You gotta be careful with how quickly you're snapping around. Just all of a sudden, just...
You don't give yourself whiplash or anything like that.
Yeah. Or have a player just fall out on the stage because he broke his own neck just snapping around.
I don't know why I'm laughing at this.
Yeah, this is terrible stuff. Why
terrible
are we laughing?
Situation we're envisioning right now.
We are terrible people, folks, just FYI.
But let's see here. Trying to see where exactly we're at in terms of getting this rebooted, folks. All right, it looks like our Observer is restarting his client right now, because I think it's an issue from the Observer side of things. So once we've got that figured out, we're going to be jumping back in game and continuing on with the action. We have been told that it's being restarted, but that first map was played out to its entirety, so...
Do we know if that map's going to count that way, though?
So, it's like I said, as far as we've been told, it's being restarted. So it should go back down to 0-0 and start again from the first map, but... We'll see. Like I said, it's just a little weird for me because it did get played out to its entirety.
So yeah.
I'm personally a little conflicted on that, but from what we've been told, it is going to be restarted. And we're just waiting, I think, for the fourth player to turn off his invisibility. Because we got back in, I still don't think we see this fourth player. We're trying to give you guys like play-by-play updates in terms of what's going on at this point. So we're still trying to figure that out.
Yeah, the invisible man has not decided to show him.
it's a really perplexing issue here from an esports perspective. As I don't think I've ever dealt with this before.
No, you typically don't see this too much. No. But granted, a lot of your 2D esports games are pretty well established titles. League of Legends, Overwatch, CS:GO, those things like.
Let's go keep the list going.
How far can you take it? Don't make me do that. I'm terrible at following 2D esports.
Let's see, Rocket League, Rainbow Six.
Okay. Call of Duty, if you wanna throw that in there. You got Dota. You have got
Guns of Boom.
Guns of Boom. Yeah,
there you go. Absolutely. That's
another one. A lot of mobile stuff actually recently becoming kind of esports popular, and that's interesting to me. Really, I never really saw the viability in that.
Arena of Valor, is one.
Okay, I'll take
it
around
now. It's like that like League of Legends-esque MOBA on mobile.
Okay.
What else we got? Let's see.
I'm sure we're missing some few like real standout ones.
Clash of Clans. Clash Royale. And then there's a third one, too, that same company made that's probably going to do some stuff, I would imagine. Brawl Stars. Because I actually have that one on my tablet, so I just went and found that one real quick. Trying to think what else.
Blue, your hot source on all mobile.
If we really want to reach, we could say like Civilization.
So, wow.
It actually has a competitive scene.
Does it really?
It's obviously not like huge.
No.
But it does have a competitive scene. Fun fact. It's just really slow.
Well, yeah. I mean, you're building an entire civilization. I think I played that like 3 times with a group of buddies.
Like you never play that game beyond a best of one.
Oh, you can't. I mean, you would literally need some sort of illicit drugs or some type of boosting keep you awake for that long. I mean, goodness, the 1 or 2 games that I played took probably 5 or 6 hours. I mean, that game is just slow moving, especially if you have somebody who doesn't want to take their turn quickly, right?
We all know too well that guy. That's why you put like 60-second limits on the turns.
That's a good point. Always time limit those, because people will abuse that time as much as they can.
Okay, so we got another update, folks, as we bring the conversation back to this current match. That map did actually count. So what I thought was going to happen, because of the fact that the players themselves never actually experienced any issues, it was all on our Observer side, and obviously, like, it's a little hard to interrupt the players in the middle of the game, that match did actually count. So it's currently 1-0 for, I believe, VRespawn.
Yes.
VRespawn is currently ahead 1-0 as a result of that. We do apologize for any of the action we missed on the first map, but obviously the action itself was a little bit hard to catch anyway because of the Spectre bug that we currently have going on. So working on fixing that as quickly as possible. The players are getting ready to jump on the map too, so it's looking like we will probably have to deal with it at least for the second map right now. We'll see that when we load into game, as that might change things a little bit for us. But let's see. Okay, I think we got all 4 back now, so we should be good, I think. Cool. Yeah!
Yay.
Awesome! It's Search and Destroy. We like couldn't remember his name for the longest time, but we've got him back. All 4 players are now visible, so we should be able to spectate this second map. But like we said before, the first map did count since it was an issue on our end, not the player's end, and as such, VRespawn are now up 1-0.
But I can say that those invisibility hacks do make casting quite different.
Yeah, that was wild, right? Just seeing people like die right in them, like the culling took out members of VRespawn randomly.
Or when you watch those old World War II movies and a guy's walking through an open field or street, and then all of a sudden you just see him drop from a sniper. Speaking of snipers,
you get really brutal with these.
I mean, I'm an Onward player by heart, man.
Yeah, that's true.
Violence is just in my blood at this point.
I guess that's coming through for you. Well, either way, violence has seemed to come through for VRespawn at the start of this matchup. They're going to go 3-0 at the beginning of this map. Well over SAS now as they try to box them out of any... What? Are you flossing, really? Did you just really floss?
You deserve to die. Oh, wait, you didn't even die. Oh.
He flossed and then he picked up his plasma rifle and just one-shot someone. What a boss. It's like, I mean, the dance move is kind of like a 5 out of 10 for me, but Yeah. More personal preference, to be fair, but
poor execution, but overall, I think.
No, the execution was great. I just don't like the move. Either way, though, this isn't becoming an incredibly one-sided matchup here for VRespawn. So he's still doing it.
Let's just be his thing when he's like in between engagements, right?
Just imagine like you're like 2 inches from someone in this game. They just floss on you and then bio pump you to death.
Oh, that's embarrassing. It'd almost be as embarrassing as getting sword killed at this point.
What? Oh my God! Stop! Stop! No!
Oh no!
Oh no! He dabbed.
Oh boy.
See, like, dabbing has become like slowly more acceptable to me. Like, it used to be like no-go territory for like doing it. Now it's slowly kind of worked its way back into it. It's like, okay, it's acceptable, but not after a floss. Like, come on, you gotta.
No, you're linking too many trends together now, buddy. You're getting out of hand.
Gotta be very careful with that.
We're gonna have to give this map to SAS just for foolish linkage of dance moves.
Well, either way, VRespawn does still have a pretty decisive lead at this point at 11-0. SAS has really failed to start here, unfortunately, in terms of their positioning, and I'd imagine weapon pickups have been a pretty rough find for them as well, although Soapcaster finally gets them onto the board with one for himself. Rugafell's missed shot there on the plasma rifle is going to cost him nearly two, as that gives a second frag over to SAS.
Well, that's an ugly mug there. That's a face only a mother could love.
It's got that like crab face going on there.
Call him crab face.
It's like the... Yeah.
You know who would be proud of those dabs from the VRespawn side, though?
Who?
Kaplan.
Yeah.
Jason.
Yeah, that's right. He loves the dab.
Yeah.
That's his workout. He just infinite dabs for 30 minutes straight every morning.
He just speed dabs.
That's how he wakes up. That's how he gets his day started. He just chugs a cup of coffee after that. Stu is going to look to pick up some more frags here in a second. Rugafell, in the meanwhile, is going to try and have some fun with the sword. I mean, they're up by, what, like eight kills
nine
until
kills,
they just
yeah.
lost their last one there. Now they're nine, so, or yeah, 10. And then, I can't do math, sorry.
So, you got me. I'm pretty good at math.
Thanks for correcting
me. Don't
worry
about it.
So they're going to try to have a little bit of fun here since the match is nearly concluded for themselves. Do mind you, this is a best of fives. They still have to close out one more. But there we go. Finally, Rugafell gives it to us. The sword kill. It's gone full ninja with it too, giving us like the posture and everything like that.
Yeah, that was excellent. It's like that kind of like wiping the blood off the blade after killing your enemy. Excellent, but it won't be enough. He will get picked, but that doesn't matter because the round is decisively won by VRespawn, taking it over SAS there. They're 2-0. Looking poised for a 3-0 here, to be completely honest with you, Blue. They're just completely outplaying SAS right now. And we did see that in their earlier matchup in the earlier part of the brackets. But I don't know. I think we're going to see VRespawn and Danglers going at it again in the finals.
Stu specifically had a really good run in that one, ended up going 7-1, so a 7.0 KD for that entire matchup there. Very impressive stuff from him. His team a little bit less at a 2.6 KD, if I recall correctly. We'll take a look at some of the highlights now. Hopefully we get the sword kill in there and the samurai execute that he managed to get for himself there.
Ooh, nice, that plasma and the pulse.
Still pretty straightforward gameplay in terms of what we come to expect.
Yeah.
I mean, ultimately, what, just like too much map control, too much control of overall for the guys on VRespawn there. A bit of a false start, you could almost say, for the guys on SAS. They never really got the ball rolling until very late, at which point, like, VRespawn had already, like, yeah, we won this. They just started, like, messing around with the sword and everything.
I mean, they
else
started flossing and...
Yeah, they were doing that before they even won. They were only, like, 5-0 at that point.
That's true. But, yeah, it was cool to see them, you know, use the opportunity while they had a bit of a break in the points to where they could try and do some stuff that's risky, like give us that sword kill that we finally wanted. We got to see
Waited all night for it. We finally got it.
Waited all night. Now I can sleep well tonight knowing that I got my sword kill, and I can thank Rugafell for that one.
All right, guys. Well, here we go. Moving into what could very well be one of our final maps of the evening, although with the way things are going, we might be jumping in to check out the grand finals as well. Mind you, it doesn't have an actual effect on the tournament besides seeding, as this will be the last qualification match for the day. And it's looking like VRespawn, or VRespawn, is going to be the team to potentially take it if they come out on top with just this final map. They're already up 2-0.
It's a plasma rifle shot and an immediate frag onto Search and Destroy from Rugafell. A great play, and then Stu Game's going to come in and pick up Saltcaster as well, and that'll be the SAS team wiped once again. It's 4-0 here so far for VRespawn. Just over 2 minutes into the match.
So, 4-0 for VRespawn. A good start again. A slow start for SAS, unfortunately, as they do have to try and find their footing here. he's taking it slow. I think we've got a bigger map than to play on two, so they have a much better, much easier time kind of avoiding the V respawn roster and hopefully getting a better engagement against them. Marukafelt, meanwhile, struggling here. Down only two shots left. To be fair, his opponent's not really doing a good job of chipping off damage on him either due to some good coverage that was placed there. But Saltcaster does manage to pick up the frag. However, it's not long before Stu comes in to trade it out. So although, yes, SAS finally get that first frag, it doesn't matter. It's still a 5-kill advantage at this point to respawn.
And SAS doing well to at least stay with each other here out of the spawn. A little bit of separation, but a little bit is good. Not too much, however. You want to be able to come in and support your teammate. VRespawn's going to go ahead and try and jump on that as they did see the cross there in the open. And it does look like their push is going to be successful. A nice headshot there at the end from Rukafel. Picks up Saltcaster, and VRespawn just go ahead and keep that lead at a comfy 5 points. It's now 8-3, just over 3 minutes in.
Yep, just keeping the status quo alive at this point for VRespawn. That's all they really need to do.
That's right.
Still got half the match left, so no reason to really mess around since they've already got a lead to play off of. Stu, though, ends up walking into a trap there. Goes down to a combination of the Hellfire Rockets and the Ricochaker just being thrown his way as he tries to come in from that bottom hatch. Won't work out at all. Finally, a free kill going the way of SAS as they bring it down to a 4-kill advantage and start to try and hunt down the other remaining member, Rukafel. But Stu's already back out on the board, so they don't have to worry about that too much. They're not really going to have that opportunity. Dual Hellfire Rockets in the meanwhile for Saltcaster. First time I think I've ever seen that. He's going to be able to get at least one frag, but the problem is he gets sniped out a second later by Stu.
Yeah, again, I think this is us seeing VRespawn feeling a bit comfortable with their point lead and trying a bit of things that they might not otherwise try. And, you know, it's not a bad idea because this is probably one of the most competitive environments you'll have. So being able to test out some strategies that you might not want to risk in regular cup play or something, you know, might not hurt here if you've got such a commanding lead. But Saltcaster going to grab Stu Games. You're going to keep the lead to 4, and it's definitely not something that they cannot overcome. We could see SAS here very well come back and pull a nice underdog comeback to secure at least one map and keep this going. But VRespawn able to get another frag and open things back up to 5 kills, where it's pretty much been this whole map.
Coming down to it once again. Now it's 6 kills with Stu finding another pickup here. We'll see if any trades end up working their way back out, but no. Rukafel with it yet. Another one, a double kill for him. Puts VRespawn up to 13. Two more. The map series and spot at the land will be theirs.
Yeah, nowhere near as much flossing or dabbing this time around, though.
No, it's all business now.
Now it's business.
No pleasure.
I don't know. Dual rocket launcher seems pretty pleasurable to me.
Well, and there's going to be a lot more pleasure as they'll be qualifying in just a second if they can pick up this final kill. Falling slightly short on that, Rukafel's not able to finish it off. So Destroy manages to make his way through the portal over to this side of the arena. Doesn't necessarily want to dive directly through it, but the follow through a moment later gets the frag that he needs. 15-7 is the final score. You can go ahead and do it now. It's not even a floss. That's a little like loop-de-doop that he was doing.